From scouting through to player development, these simple tips will ensure you make the most of the Youth Academy in FIFA 23 Career Mode. If you have one, make full use of your homegrown talent. Homegrown talents are a pre-order bonus and are easily identified in a specific email. They're easy to spot with their high overall and potential, and their 2D mini face has the club kit. At the start of every new career mode, you will have some players already in the Youth Academy, and you could fall lucky as well as your homegrown talent, you could find a gem. However, this is a very rare occurrence, as most of the time the players already in the Youth Academy are pretty poor. Now, the next tip is pretty obvious, and that is to get the best scouts you can with the budget you have available. So the quality of scouts are scored by two attributes: experience, meaning they will find a larger number of players, and judgment, meaning they will find a better quality of player. So again, it's pretty obvious that the higher the star rating, the more that scout will cost. So like I said, get the best you can afford with the budget you have available. But when you're using a top flight club, ideally you want 5-star experience and 5-star judgment scouts. Now you have your Youth Academy scouts, it's time to decide where you're going to send them to. Statistically, the regions that cost more to scout in should return the best quality of players when using good scouts, and these regions are North, Central and Southern Europe and South America. If you're not looking for any specific position, then I recommend leaving the player type as any. However, the most commonly found positions when scouting for technically gifted are central midfield, central attacking midfield, and wide midfield. For winger, you will naturally find wingers, wide midfielders, and pacey type strikers. Physically strong, you will find central defensive midfield, centre-back, full-back and powerful number 9 type strikers. Playmaker, you will find central midfield, central attacking midfield, wide midfield and centre-forward. I think goalkeeper is pretty self-explanatory. Attacker, you will find central attacking midfield, winger and centre-forward. And finally, defensive-minded are most likely to find full-back and wing-back. Always leave a couple of days in between your scout reports returning. I always get mine to come back on the 3rd and the 7th and then the 10th. This is so you can take advantage of each scout report individually rather than all three coming at once. And this tip is instrumental in the next few tips working correctly. Always save your game the day before your first scout report arrives. So for me, whose first scout report returns on the 3rd, I will always save my game on the 2nd. And by doing this, you can take advantage of this next naughty tip. Upon receiving your first scout report, if all the players are rubbish, you can then simply exit the career mode and reload the save from the day before your first scout report arrived. Now, yes, a lot of people will call this cheating, but I prefer to call it manipulating the game to our advantage, and repeat this process until you're happy with your scout report. Now, even though they are quite rare, it is very easy to spot a future Youth Academy star in the initial scout report. So the first thing I am always drawn to is the maximum potential. That should always be 94. And then look at the overall range. The highest of the two numbers should be in the high 60s as minimum. And then look at the player value, and I personally never accept any player under 1 million. So if you're lucky enough to find a player who ticks all these boxes, immediately save your game and then repeat the last couple of tips for the next scout reports. So if you successfully followed the last few tips, you should now have a few quality players in your Youth Academy. As soon as your players are signed to the Youth Academy, it's time to start with their development plans. Whether that be to retrain a new position or upgrade skill moves, weak foot or work rates. Keep an eye on when each individual development plan is complete and then start the next one. And the easiest way to keep on top of development plans is to wait till the first of the month when you will receive your youth squad monthly report. As well as development plans, the youth squad monthly report is a good way to monitor players' overall growth and their potential. And with every passing month, some Youth Academy players' potential will narrow, meaning some of them may no longer be good enough for your club. I always leave my players in the Youth Academy until January. At that point, as we've just mentioned, if there are any that are no longer good enough, have to be ruthless and release them. But for those that are good enough and are either 16 or 17 years of age, I will promote them through to the senior side so we can get them sent out on loan. Which leads us perfectly onto the final tip of the video, that if your youth academy graduates aren't first team ready for the level of your team, then get them sent out on loan. Now, because of their high potential, youth academy graduates are very easy to loan out and should get plenty of offers. Try to loan your youth academy graduates to a team that is lower rated than the one you are managing. That way, they should get plenty of game time. Youth Academy graduates that are successfully sent out on loan will still grow nicely in overall, and it should protect their potential upon recall. So by following all these very simple tips, you are now ready to start a Youth Academy career mode in FIFA 23. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please remember to tune in next time. Well, until then, it's FCG out.